Thank you for coming to hear me talking. Someone asked me, how long are you going to talk? Well, I don't know. Talking is my mental exercise. As you get older, we all are, you exercise your brain. It's good for your health. Make you think. You read the paper, magazine, books, and watch television. It's good for you. You have to think. Don't let brain go lazy. You have to think. And this is good for your mental health. Make you healthy. So we all should exercise our brain. Brain is the one control our body. So use your brain. Think. Today's topic is what do we expect happen in 2014? It's already May. Time goes fast. There are many things we can talk about what will happen in 2014, but I will concentrate in three topics: politics, economics, and technology. It already happened in sports. We had the Winter Olympic in Sochi, Russia. United States won second prize. We're competing with Norway, Netherlands, Germany, Canada, Russia. Russia, host country, won first prize. America with the second prize. That was not bad. I'm sure you all watched very exciting games. Another sports coming this year is the World Cup soccer game. It will happen in Rio de Janeiro in Brazil in June, July. This is the most popular game in the world. In America, it's not that popular, but all over the world, soccer game is the number one popular game. In Brazil, they are preparing for this World Cup game in June, July. They are spending billions of dollars building hotel, building the stadium, building the highway, railroad. They spend a lot of money investing in order to encourage people to come. The millions of people will come. And I read the paper that hotel, you have to make reservation, hotel cost you $500 a night, hotel. And the meal is expensive. So you cost a lot of money to go there, but millions of people come to watch the game. Brazil is known as a good team. They hope to win as a host country. But the main topic is the politics. This year, the big countries, democratic countries, are having elections. India, Indonesia, Brazil, two democratic countries are having elections. Firstly, in India. India, last 10 years, Prime Minister Singh was Prime Minister for 10 years. Under him, the economy was 8% a year. For the last 2 years, it dropped to 3% in 2 years. He has achieved a lot, like a peaceful relationship with Pakistan, Muslim country, and neighboring country China, and economic improvement. But this year election, Congress Party is not going to win. The Congress Party has been dominating India for last half century. The Congress Party is starting with Jawaharlal Nehru, the Prime Minister, and Mahatma Gandhi. The two men brought independence of India from Great Britain, starting in 1947. And they organized the Congress Party. They controlled India for last half century. But this time, they are not going to win. The opposition party is Nehru, India's most conservative Hindu party, and a man named Modi, M-O-D-I, Modi, he is expected to win the presidential election. He is known as a very decisive decision-making politician. He has been governor of one big province, and he is known for being a good governor. So he's expecting to win, and he promised to restore economics and clean up the corruption, which is the main problem in India. India's problem is not only corruption, but unemployment and economic recovery. They have a problem of infrastructure. Children cannot go to school. The highway and electricity is unavailable. They have a lot of problems. And millions of people live in the street. I was in India. I talked to Indian people. How come government don't take care of those people in the street? And they said, you know, those people in the street, they enjoy living like that. But I don't believe it. The millions of people live in the street. Nothing like that in China. No beggar in street, no street people live in the street. They left up 40 million people from poverty to middle class in China. But in India, they have left millions of people, but still millions of people are on the street. Now this man, Modi, if he wins, he can recover economics and he wants to clean up the corruption. He promised and the people believe in it. The problem with him is he's a Hindu conservative and he's anti-Muslim. The Muslim is a minority group in India, and under his governor in the Providence, they had trouble with the Muslim. Hindu, several people were killed by Muslim, so to revenge against the Muslim, the Hindu killed Muslim, 1,000 Muslim in his province. But this man Modi is responsible for governing. He did not apologize. So he is known as an anti-Muslim Hindu. So in India, that is going to be a problem. So he will be good president, for he has that handicap, anti-Muslim. That's India they have election, they are voting, 800 million people are voting, the largest country in the world voting, and the largest democratic country in the world, but they are voting now. It takes about 7 weeks to get the result. After India, Indonesia is the next big country, 250 million people, Indonesia, we don't know much about. And there's the one young politician, 52 years old, known as Jabaki. He is a mayor of one big city, Javarina city, and he's known as a decision maker and a clean politician and open policy. He invites citizens to discuss politics. So no corruption with the man. And he is going to be presidential candidate. In Indonesia, plan is, in order to be presidential candidate, your party must win 20% of members in the parliament. Now, they had a parliament election, and this Jabotsky's party did not win 20% parliament members, only 19%. So he has to have a coalition with a minority group, which he will. And then he will become a presidential candidate, most likely he will win. That's, he will change, he'll shake up the Indian, Indonesian politics when he becomes a president. The next country is Brazil. Brazil President Rosa woman is going to rerun for a second election. And she was popular, and she lost popularity recent protests. There are thousands of people in the street all over the country protest for raising bus fare. Bus fare was raised in Brazil, so the people protest. So they had to adjust the bus fare. So she gained back a little bit, but she, unless she wins 50% of election, she has to rerun. The most likely that will happen. There are opposition, Social Democrats and the Socialist Party, two opposition, very strong candidate, and they will fight against Ross president. So if a president win a second rerun, he will be second term president. Under President and the previous President Lula, last 10 years, the Brazil changed poverty population. 10 million people got out of poverty, went up to middle class. So in all Latin America, it's a well-stabilized country. And many of them are run by left from the center party. Brazil, Venezuela, Latvia, Chile, Argentina, Ecuador, Uruguay, many of them are socialist. And they are stabilized region. The economic increase is 3%, better than most other regions in the world. Next election is in United Kingdom. Scotland wants to have independence, getting out of United Kingdom. But unlikely that will happen. If that happens, they will have an impact on Spain and Canada. In Spain, Catalonia province, the largest province, wants to have independence from Spain, and they are very powerful, and the Spanish government absolutely opposed, but they are going to have a referendum. If Scotland wins, that will affect in Spain. Also in Canada, Quebec, French-speaking, Quebec also wants independence. When Quebec had they twice referendum, but they lost, but they are going to have again. If you go to Quebec, if you ask people direction, they don't answer you unless you speak French. You have to speak English in Quebec. You don't speak French. If you speak English, they don't talk to you. Now, the main election is in midterm election in the United States in November. Republican Party wants to win Senate majority. There are 6 Senate is on the race, and the Republican win those 6 Senate, they will become majority. So they will have both majority in the House, majority in the Senate. The Republican don't trust President Obama, and President Obama cannot do anything at domestic policy because Republicans do not cooperate. Obama wants to raise the tax on the rich people.